people to serve.
Back here with Greg Jennings. All right, Greg, we're going viral. So the Carolina Hurricanes were in Toronto on Saturday to take on the Maple Leafs. And after both of their goalies went down with injuries, they had to turn to David Ayers, the Zamboni driver, yes, who doubles as the third string goalie on call for either team in case of emergency. Well, there was an emergency. Ayers allowed two goals on the first two shots he faced, but then saved the next eight shots, helping Carolina get the
win. Carolina won.
Take a listen to how it all ended.
3 seconds left. Here's Clifford, stopped by David Ayers. The Carolina Hurricanes surround him and defeat the Toronto Maple Leafs 6-3. I'm sure that sweater goes to the Hall of Fame. Number 90 will live on for the Carolina Hurricanes, 42 years of age. Here he is, named one of the stars of the game, and there's another first, and something he probably never thought he'd get a chance to do. And good for the fans here to show their appreciation of what he had to do tonight.
It's been great. Obviously, that second period was a little shaky, but I told the boys in the dressing room, once we come up for the third, I'll be settled down and ready to win this one.
I mean, your last game of record that we could find was Allen Cup hockey 5 years ago. How would you just describe what tonight was?
It was awesome. Obviously, the time of my life out there. I've been on this ice many times without fans. Put fans in the mix, and it's a whole different game, obviously. But, hey, once in a lifetime, I'll take it.
That is awesome.
If people don't understand just quickly how it works, each city has a guy there in reserve in case in a game either a team loses both goalies. And then he's got to play. This guy doubles a Zamboni driver in Toronto. And boom, in the game, Greg.
But could you see this being implemented in NFL circles? Two quarterbacks go down.
Instead of having, Mohamed Sanu be your emergency third quarterback?
I mean, it would be so intriguing for fans, though, if that was the case.
Yeah, the guy would also die.
He would definitely die. I wouldn't say he would die, but he would come close.
It wouldn't. I feel like in baseball, it could happen. They should implement it. So I'm about baseball, trying to turn the page. If you're out of pitchers, you don't get to go to a position player. You got to have a guy. You got to have a guy, preferably a fan, random fan.
I've never known that.
That's an awesome story.
It's an awesome story.
It's a very cool story. Age 42, the guy's driving the Zamboni. He's done with hockey 5 years prior. All of a sudden, he's on the ice in an NHL game.
Wow.
In Jenna's previous life as Today Show host,
here we go.
After her life as longtime sports host
here
and sports reporter.
Where?
No, this is not. No, no, no.
Okay.
The amount of time we're spending today on Lakers Celtics, you guys spend 0 seconds on it, but David Ayers is a Today Show story made of gold.
Our top story this morning, his name is David Ayers.
Yes.
Yes. That is very funny.
Absolutely. It's a great story. Happy for him. What a cool story.
All right, we mentioned the NFL. Let's talk NFL. Greg, we're talking about your former quarterback, Aaron Rodgers. At 36 years old, you're not going to find too many people who think his window is closed. Don't forget, though, Brett Favre was even younger than Aaron Rodgers when the team drafted Rodgers. Now, according to Green Bay's GM, the team will not rule out taking a quarterback in the first round of this year's draft. Greg, you were there for the transition from Favre to Rodgers. Do you think the Packers should already be thinking about life after Aaron Rodgers?
Yes. Yeah, absolutely. There is no other position in football that you're not thinking life after that individual. Whether it's receiver, whether it's defensive end, whether it's linebacker, whether it's offensive lineman.
But it's Aaron Rodgers.
He's a guy that has gone down in the past, and we've seen the play of the Green Bay Packers non-existence offensively. So, yes, if you're trying to establish winning ways and you talk about the next man up philosophy, which every team in sport talks about, you have to do this. He was a guy that was drafted. Obviously, he wanted to be drafted higher. He fell down to the Green Bay Packers. Brett Favre was still there. He had to wait his turn, but he had an opportunity to learn from a guy whether they had a great relationship or not. You were in the room. You saw him work. You saw how things were operated. You were able to draw those experiences and add a little bit to your game, which helped him become the player that we now see. I wouldn't see why they would even not consider looking at getting a guy when Aaron Rodgers can still show a young guy the ropes, not so much tutor him or whatever, but you have an opportunity to watch him while he's still in his prime, maybe sliding down that slot.
Favre's last year in Green Bay, you guys, maybe it was last year, second last year, you remind me. You guys had one more great season after you drafted Aaron Rodgers.
Yes.
You guys, with Favre. I think it was his last year. His last year there. That's what I thought. You guys made a conference championship game?
Yep.
Okay. Did Aaron help you guys that season? No.
No.
He didn't play because Favre never missed anything.
Exactly.
Favre never missed time. You think a star defensive end in his third year, which is what that pick would have been at that point in time, would have helped you guys? You think you guys could have been a little bit better if in that season, if you hadn't drafted Aaron Rodgers? That season. That then, right then and there.
Yeah, I see where you're going, Nick, but you can't play the game that way.
Well, I understand that.
Because if Brett would have gone down, we would have had Aaron.
Of course. And it ended up working out great because Aaron Rodgers is Aaron bleeping Rodgers, and he's one of the greatest quarterbacks ever, and he won a Super Bowl. But Aaron Rodgers, the next one, is not going to be available in the late first round of this year's draft. If Tua Tagovailoa somehow falls and he's available like Aaron was, a guy who could have gone number one overall and instead falls to the 20s, then sure, Green Bay, do it. And Brian Gutekunst, I understand you saying this because you want a team to maybe trade with you or trade to try to feel, oh, we got to take a quarterback. You don't want to give out accurate information. But if the Packers draft a quarterback this year, if I'm Aaron Rodgers, I am as angry as I've ever been. And by the way, I know Favre was probably pretty upset about it when they did it then, but at least with Brett, you had seen not only the play trail off, but you also wondered, how close are we? Like, are we a championship team still right now? Packers made the conference championship game 2 months ago. They wouldn't be drafting a quarterback as Aaron Rodgers' insurance in the first round. They would be drafting a quarterback as Aaron Rodgers' ultimate replacement in the first round. You're too close with too few title chance years left. And the fact of the matter probably is this. Packers about to be in the quarterback wilderness for the first time in 30 years.
So when would you suggest? Because when you look at teams who want to build and create winning ways, you can't wait until the window is completely closed to then now make a move. You have to make a move during.
Yeah, but usually, but I feel like because it's the Packers and because they're one of the few teams that has gone from Hall of Famer straight to Hall of Famer, we act like that is a realistic path to do it again. No matter when they draft their next quarterback, they're almost assuredly going to be in the wilderness for some time. If somehow let's say Rodgers got hurt this year and they were sitting there at number two or three. It's like, man, we can get a star blue chipper, even though we have time left with Aaron, then fine, so be it. But the level of quarterbacks that we're talking about, Justin Herbert, if he's there, to draft him with the hope being he doesn't play at all for at least 2 or 3 years while Aaron is still playing, and to, even if it's just by 2 or 3%, lessen your chance of winning a championship before Aaron Rodgers is done, to me would be crazy.
But we're also in this age now where we don't know if we have the next Breeze or the next Tom Brady that are going to play into their 40s. Look what's going on with the Saints right now and with the Patriots. The Patriots had someone. He was waiting. You know, and Brady never stopped playing. And for the last 2 years or so, the Saints had Teddy Bridgewater ready to go. We still don't know what the situation is going to be there. I think it's a tough situation when you don't know now, when these guys are playing into their 40s, how much time do you really have left unless they're injury prone?
Yeah, and what that time you have left looks like. I think that is what everybody's going to have to focus on. Like, if you're a team and you're assessing your talent and Aaron Rodgers is a part of that talent, you have to be realistic. And you have to look at the things that you sometimes want to overlook and say, you know what, is he starting to look a little different? Should we start preparing? Because every other position, as I mentioned, you do that for. If there is a running back that you feel like the wear and tear is surmounting, you start to consider other options.
But the Packers just made it very clear. They believe Rodgers got a bunch of prime years left. They just made him the highest paid player ever, right? They did that a year ago. you can't do that and then a year later, when you make the conference championship game, say, all right, we are now hedging our bets. You are all in on the Aaron Rodgers era. And I don't think you draft an injury replacement, a true backup quarterback in the first round. I think you draft your next starting quarterback in the first round. So if the story was the Packers might target a quarterback with their third round pick so they're not totally screwed if Aaron gets hurt, then I'm with you. Sure. The first round pick's too valuable. The first round pick is a player who, if you draft the right guy, can help you win a championship now, this year. It's the NFL, not the NBA. Rookies help you immediately if you get the right guy at the right position.
I agree and disagree at the same time because I was a second round draft pick and I was able to help that team right.
Agreed. Right. That speaks to my point that you can get high. There's going to be 60 awesome players in this draft that will help teams in the 2020 season. The Packers would be passing on someone to help them this year in order to look to a future that's murky once Aaron's gone.
Do you remember how well Ben Roethlisberger took it when, what's his name,
Mason Rudolph.
When Mason Rudolph was drafted?
Yeah, not great.
Take a break. Coming up, hey, why was Dez Bryant working out with Patrick Mahomes? Next on First Things First.